for the soul of Josephine Gonzalez, that the good Lord may receive her soul in peace. And together with the intentions we have, praying for all the souls, inscribe the envelopes in the envelopes here at the altar, we begin our celebration. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Glory to God.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Wisdom is found by those who seek her. A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Resplendent and unfading is wisdom, and she is readily perceived by those who love her, and found by those who seek her. She hastens to make herself known in anticipation of their desire. Whoever watches for her at dawn shall not be disappointed, for he shall find her sitting by his gate. For taking thought of wisdom is the perfection of prudence, and whoever for her sake keeps vigil shall quickly be free from care. Because she makes her rounds, she makes her own rounds, seeking those worthy of her, and graciously appears to them in ways, and meets them with all solicitude. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My soul is fasting for you, O Lord my God. My soul is fasting for you, O Lord my God. O God, you are my God, O my sin. For you my flesh pines and my soul thirsts.
Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. The foolish ones, when taking their lamps, brought no oil with them, but the wise brought flasks of oil with their lamps. Since the bridegroom was long delayed, they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, there was a cry, "Behold, the bridegroom, come out to meet him." Then all those virgins got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish ones said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise ones replied, "No, for there may not be enough for us and for you. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves." While they went off to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready to meet, who were ready, went into the wedding feast with him. Then the door was locked. Afterwards, the other virgins came and said, "Lord, Lord, open the door for us." But he said in reply, "Amen, I say to you, I do not know you. Therefore, stay awake, for you know neither the day nor the hour." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
God is good. I welcome you to this 32nd Sunday in ordinary time. We are almost towards the end of the year, the end of liturgical year. We are remaining with two Sundays, then we begin a new season. And as we come to the end of the year, today we are called to think of the last things in our lives. The coming of the Lord. The day of the Lord. And here we are called upon to live our life with wisdom. To be vigilant. To be alert. Because none of us knows the day or the hour when the Lord will come to visit you and say, "Come and go with me." None of us knows. And we hear again the gospel. At midnight, there was a cry, "Behold, the bridegroom, come out to meet him." When they said at midnight, it is the a day or the hour when sometimes we are not aware The Lord comes in a surprise. Come, here I am. So we are called to be wise, to be alert, to be vigilant. Every time, every day, let us live it as if it's the last day of our life in this world. Every time, let us be ready to meet the Lord. As we celebrate this Sunday, the following Sundays are going to talk about the last things, the judgment, meeting of the Lord, the talents and all that. How are we living our lives today? So we are called to be vigilant and alert by using the wisdom we have as a gift from God to put our faith into practice. And in the gospel of today, we hear Jesus saying, "What can I compare the kingdom of God with? It is like the 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom." The kingdom of God is a celebration because it gives this example of a bridegroom, is a marriage. Marriage is a celebration. So as we wait for the kingdom of God, we have to be people of joy, people who celebrate. But how can we celebrate? Is when we are alert and vigilant. When we use the gifts we receive with prudence and we wait for the Lord patiently. The 10 virgins were all aware that the Lord is coming. They went out to meet him with their lamps. 5 of them, we hear, they were foolish, and 5 were wise. And why foolish and wise? The foolish ones are those ones who carry the lamps without extra oil. Without extra oil. They just took it for granted. They never minded. They were not wise to have oil in their smaller vessels. The wise one, on top of carrying the lamps, they carried oil in small vessels. They were prepared for uncertainties. As Christians, we are always hoping. Let us be prepared to meet the Lord. The oil are the acts, the actions, the deeds, those of faith, hope we have in our lives as Christians. In fact, the liturgy of today is calling us to be vigilant and ready to meet the Lord whatever day he comes. In the first reading, we are given the symbol of wisdom, the woman, Sophia, the wisdom. In fact, in the time of Jesus, Isis was the goddess of culture, was an influential figure in the world around the Israel. She may have influenced the portrait of Lady Wisdom in the Wisdom of Solomon and other wisdom books. The exhortation to watch out for wisdom prepares us for the bridesmaids who look out for the bridegroom in the gospel. In a nutshell, the psalm we have just heard, "My soul is thirsting for you, my God," continues the theme of watching. Because to thirst is to watch, to be alert, to seek. The only ambition of the speaker in the psalm is to find God. Ordinary human needs like food, heavy clothing, or going outing, or going to sleep, were just secondary. His utmost priority in his life was to seek for the Lord. Such a person will be ready when the bridegroom comes. And how can you be alert? Evaluate yourself, your acts. Give accountability of your acts. The psalmist of today says, like a deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul is thirsting for you, my God. Are we really thirsting for God? Are we here knowing where we are? Are we here knowing that we are in the house of God, we have to open our hearts to the graces of God?
through listening attentively the word of God. Being humble in church and receiving the Holy Communion with reverence and faith. Are we thirsting for the Lord and we know Him? The second reading, in a nutshell, the Christians of Thessalonians were worried about death. They believed in the imminent return of Christ. But what of those who already died before His return? Would they miss salvation? Paul comes in to remind them of the resurrection of Christ. If Christ rose, the Christian who died will also rise too with Him, because they were baptized in His name. God will bring them to Himself in a new exodus. To express this, St. Paul uses apocalyptic language about, like, archangels, the trumpets, the clouds transporting the faithful to heaven. These traditional descriptions of God's power were to assure the Christians at the time of St. Paul that alive or dead, they will be with the Lord. They belong to the Lord. What mattered was to have that faith and hope in Jesus. With Christ in paradise, they were to continue enjoying the joy of being with God, which they received in baptism. With this knowledge, they could comfort one another. They could come to console one another. And they did that with the words of wisdom. Those especially looking for wisdom and those awaiting for the kingdom of God, they were able to encourage others with the same spirit. We as Christians, we are called upon to continue being vigilant and alert. Because when we do that, then the kingdom of heaven is assured to us. In the gospel, in a nutshell, we are given the last moments of meeting the Lord. And here they spoke of the signs and the farewells and all that. And this can be cited out even when Jacob spoke to his sons, Moses to the people of Israel, and Solomon also spoke the same. And in the New Testament, Paul addressed the elders of Ephesus about the returning of the Lord. Jesus concludes his description of the coming of the Son of Man with three parables, all on the topic of delay. I don't know why Jesus decided to delay. Did he want you to keep on working and walking in his ways? The answer is deep in your life. None of us knows the day or the hour when he will come. Keep on working. Keep on walking in the light of Christ. Early Christians expected a swift return of Christ. The first parable which talks about the return of Christ is about the steward who, instead of making proper preparation for his master's return, he lived a life of violence, drunkenness. We read also the parable 10 of this one we have just read today. It takes up themes familiar in this gospel to explain the return of Christ. The bridegroom represents the return of Christ himself, who comes in a surprise. Jesus had earlier called himself the bridegroom who would come one day and be taken away. Who would one day be taken away, and his disciples would call upon him and could fast and weep. We are called as Christians to recognize the biblical images of God being married to his people. The bridesmaids who coped with the delay by buying sufficient oil represent the Christians, you and me, who practice a life of responsible discipleship as we wait for the Lord. The bridesmaids who allowed their lamps to go out of oil portray those who do not value the time allotted to them. They don't use well their time and talents. They take things for granted. If we look in the world today, there are those average Christians. After baptism, confirmation, and marriage, the church has become a mystery at a distance. Those are the Christians who did not carry extra oil, who have no extra oil in their lives. They say, we shall meet the Lord since we are Christians. Things don't work in that way. Their cry to the bridegroom on his arrival is identical with the complaints of those rejected at the end of the sermon on the mountain. The idleness and the lack of preparation is a source to be rejected by the Lord. We who are here today, we are called to be alert. Let us not be rejected by the Lord at the last time. We have all the means at our hands. In fact, there were 10 maids. 5 were foolish, 5 were wise. The only thing that differentiated the foolish from the wise was that they went along with some extra oil. And that is the oil you and me will have. That's why we are keeping on coming. That's why we are keep on professing the faith. But let this faith be in action. Let this faith move us to accept certain challenges in life. They did not depend on the oil in their lamps. Don't depend on only the faith you received in baptism, in confirmation, or from your parents. One distinguishing quality of winners, I remember once upon a time I participated in some, is their commitment to excellence, dedication to excellence. I mean, it's all the challenges they are committed to excellence. They follow the dictum, whatever is worth doing at all is worth doing it well. Don't do it halfway or 50-50 like the 5 foolish virgins. Do it well. Have you ever had the experience of consulting a service provider, for example, a mechanic, a painter, a builder, you can name them, only to realize they did not do the job the way you wanted? They did only halfway the job. Wise persons, as we are today, I believe, go beyond solving a problem. They go to the extra mile to locate the source of the problem to avoid repeating the process. Let us be wise. In this parable we have had today, the foolish virgins took the one thing necessary for a bottle of oil as for granted. They assumed the oil in their lamp would be enough. Sometimes we behave like them. We assume our parents' spirituality, our parents' prayers, our brothers' prayers is enough to get us into heaven. We go wrong. My mother is praying for me. My father is in the church. My brother is a priest, is praying for me, therefore I'll go to heaven. My father is a choir master. I'll go to heaven. We are wrong. Salvation is personal. It needs your personal collaboration with God. Some Christians assume the catechism classes they attended while growing up are enough. Some have never read even the Bibles or the spiritual books. Even they don't know their dates of baptism. They feel that they are good to go since they were taught Christian religious education in schools. Once, I met a certain young man who was very good, who went to a Catholic boarding school, like some of you who were in Catholic school, who are in Catholic schools, where he used to attend morning masses every day. Upon graduation, he said the masses he attended for 6 years were enough to cover for the rest of his life. He never wanted to attend to masses anymore. The church became an enemy to him. This is another example of how we behave like the foolish virgins. This is how we carry the oil on in the lamps without extra oil. My dear friends in Christ, we are called upon to be wise by being vigilant, prepared, ready, and alert at all times. For this is the will of God, that we keep the candle of faith burning until the end of time. This will of God is not disregarding man, but God himself who gave us this will, and will be locked out when the bridegroom arrives. The pain of crying, open, open, Lord, for me. And you'll say, I don't know you. I have never known you. But I'm baptized. I attended a Christian religious education. I attended the confirmation courses. I don't know you. Without actions, we are just superficial Christians. If you live on earth as though God does not exist, how do you hope to spend eternity with God whom you have rejected, whom you have ignored? Do not just be an average Christian. Be wise. Carry some extra oil along with your lamp. Be authentic Christian. Keep on working and walking in the ways of Christ. At the end of time, you will hear the words of Christ, come to me, you blessed of the Lord. I was hungry, you gave me to eat. I was naked, you gave me something to dress. I was a stranger, you welcomed me. Let us be attentive and vigilant, that at the end of time, we meet the Lord. This is invitation not to worry, but be happy. Live positive with active faith, and all will be well at the end of time. Oh God, save me from the foolishness and taking spiritual things for granted, that at the end of time I may meet you when I'm full of joy, now and forever.
Amen. Our response is, Loving Father, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, hear our prayer.
For the church, that we may exercise wisdom in preparing for the Lord's coming into our hearts and at the end of time, we pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear our prayers.
That as residents of this planet, we may exercise our wisdom to see the signs of climate change around us and work to lessen the dire consequences of global warming, we pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear our prayers.
For all those who are victims of physical or sexual abuse, those who are expecting a child, and those who are facing death, either their own or that of a loved one, that both may be aware of the Lord's constant presence through each stage of our life, we pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear our prayers.
For our parishioners and our beloved ones who have gone to the Almighty God before us, especially those we are praying through the entire month of November, those names we have inscribed on our All Souls envelopes, that they may enjoy the company of the Lord, we pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear our prayers.
That our parish community may have the generosity and the wisdom to assist those who may suffer from the cold during the coming winter season, especially the homeless, those who find it difficult for adequate heat of their homes, we pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear our prayers.
That a
us pause to add our own intentions in the silence of our hearts. For ourselves and all those in need of our prayers, those listed on our parish bulletin, we pray that the prayers we hold in our hearts will be united with those of our patrons, St. Philip and James, and all who stand before the throne of the Lamb. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, the Father, hear our prayers.
God, our Father, this our humble prayers we present to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Away from your slumber. Santo.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Timothy, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them to the light of your face. And also we pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coherent to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of God, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
we are going to see that day.